Greek composer and politician Mikis Theodorakis died Thursday at age 96. A notice on his website cited cardiopulmonary arrest as the cause of death. Theodorakis' music for the film Zorba the Greek became a worldwide shorthand for a seize-the-moment kind of joyfulness. However, Theodorakis endured a lot of tragedy, and he was a much more complicated person than Zorba the Greek and its most famous song, A Carefree Dance, would suggest. Theodorakis was imprisoned, tortured and exiled multiple times, the first time during World War II, as a resistance fighter, again during the brutal Greek Civil War of the 1950s, and then again in the 1960s, when he was already internationally famous, by a military junta which banned his music. His leftist politics and his music went hand in hand, as he told NPR's Morning Edition in 1994. I wanted to unite the popular and the serious, he explained, and to make a popular symphony, a popular oratorio. I put one question, to whom I compose? My answer is I wanted to address to all my people, and if I write music for the Greek people, I compose for all the people. I write for all the peoples, for all the world. Mikis Theodorakis was born on July 29, 1925, on the Greek island of Chios. His father was a civil servant, and the family moved frequently across the country from post to post. Mikis wrote his first songs as a child, already enraptured by music. In 1943, while Greece was occupied by the Nazis and Mussolini's Italian forces, Theodorakis was living in the town of Tripoli on the Greek mainland. There, he was arrested and tortured for hitting an Italian officer. Afterwards, his family sent him to Athens. Once in the capital, he began studying music at the Athens Conservatory, but also joined a resistance group and guarded Jews in hiding. Almost immediately after the end of World War II, Greece descended into a bitter civil war that lasted 3 years. During one demonstration in downtown Athens, Theodorakis was arrested, beaten by the police, and left in a morgue for dead. He was hospitalized for months with a fractured skull. During the remainder of the war, the composer was repeatedly arrested and held in a notorious camp for political prisoners, where he was again tortured. In 1954, Theodorakis managed to get to France, where he enrolled at the Paris Conservatory. His teachers there included composer Olivier Messiaen. 3 years later, one of his pieces, the first suite for orchestra and piano, won a gold medal at a Moscow competition, and among his champions in Russia was Dmitri Shostakovich. The Greek musician was on his way to a significant career as a classical composer with commissions, including one for a ballet from London's Covent Garden, rolling in. But Theodorakis felt himself increasingly inspired by contemporary Greek poetry, popular music and folk instruments like the bouzouki, and in 1960, he decided to return to his homeland, despite the continuing political instability there. In 1963, he met singer Maria Farantiuri, who became his muse for decades. She was just 16. He was 2 decades older. But they connected instantly, as she told NPR in 2018. Theodorakis wrote songs, symphonies, ballets, and operas, served in parliament and as a government minister. But by 1994, he told NPR, he felt his countrymen had lost their way. Subscribe now for more updates and news.